Hello friends, I am Stephanie Haney and I am so happy to have you here with me for your good news break for the week with a little show we like to call It's All Good News. Here's what we've got for you this week. First, one of our three news directors has a very sweet baby who at a very early age has already decided she is not a morning person. You have to see this adorable but sleepy little turkey. Plus, One Actors Foundation has reached a major milestone with money raised to try and beat Parkinson's disease. And we get to witness quite the surprise. We'll share with you a sweet military moment. You might want to have the tissues ready for this one. But first, we start in Strongsville, where one boy got a surprise from his own classmates. Meet Noah. He's 9 years old and a student at Sarar Elementary School. He was also recently diagnosed with bone cancer, so now Noah is looking at 28 weeks of chemotherapy, surgery, and physical therapy. Now, with Halloween this week, Noah won't be able to celebrate like he has in the past, so his classmates got together and gave him his own Halloween drive-by parade. They all wore their favorite costumes and waved from their cars. You can see that they are rooting for their buddy, and Noah, we are too. There's a GoFundMe page to help support him and his family right now, and if you'd like to check it out, you can find that link on WKYC.com. Now, check this out. A worker at Amazon's Euclid facility has something to smile about today. Her name is Arnita, and she just won $500,000 in the company's COVID vaccine lottery contests. She says she went in on her day off to log some overtime, and that's when she got the amazing news that she was the big winner.
I sat down in a chair in front of a laptop, FaceTiming with a manager away, and she said, well, congratulations, you're one of the winners. And I'm like, oh my God. And then she said, you want to know how you know how much you won? I was like, yes. And she told me $500,000. I just started crying.
$500,000. Wow. Now, what makes the story even better is how much Arnita deserved this. She has been working so hard. She's had to borrow money from her retirement savings when the pandemic began. But look at her now. She still cannot believe that this is happening to her.
I was so excited. I just started thanking God because this is a blessing and a miracle to me. I never would have thought. I'm like, me? Are you sure you had the right person?
We love to see it, and we love to share your good news. So how about you help us do that? If you have seen something good or had something good happen to you lately, we need you to tell us about it. You can do that by using the hashtag GoodNewsCLE when you post online with your pictures and videos. You can also share what's good with you through the WKYC app using the Near Me feature. Just tap on Near Me in the bottom right corner, and the app will tell you what to do from there. It is super easy. Now, this next story comes from one of our directors, Brooke Roshong. Her daughter, Ryan, is almost 4 months old and already calling the shots. Look at what she does when her dad, Carl, tries to get her up in the morning.
Ryan, wake up. Ryan, wake up. Ryan, wake up, kid. Don't you tell me no.
The sass. She's like, Dad, it's too early. We gotta hit that snooze button a few more times. Me too, girl. Me too. Okay, it is always great running into old friends, right? Well, this puppy love moment shows that holds true for all of the animal kingdom. One-year-old Monty was on a walk with his owner when he noticed another dog that looked a lot like him. Well, when Monty crossed paths with Rosie, they started hugging. So their owner started chatting and realized they are from the same litter. How cool is that? I hope that they get to hang out because that move right there is just too sweet. Now, check this out. At Norton Women's and Children's Hospital in Louisville, Kentucky, they are onboarding a new staff member and everyone already loves her. This is Edie. She's a 2-year-old golden retriever and she's joining the team in the kids' emergency department to help give emotional support to patients. And when the time is right, encourage them to get out of bed to walk and play.
Edie will support patients through a variety of medical procedures, like helping with an IV start or a laceration repair. She can also help our younger patients with medicine taking or pill swallowing. You might find her encouraging a patient to take her for a walk around the unit, or just lending her soft paw as a source of comfort and distraction.
And Edie is getting a new coworker soon. Northwestern Mutual donated $68,000 to the Heal Dog Heal program to bring another pup to the hospital. Now, when the new pup arrives, that will make a pack of 10 dogs serving different hospitals in the system. The more the merrier, right? And how about this for a benchmark? Michael J. Fox's Foundation for Parkinson's Research has now officially raised more than $1 billion, with a B, dollars. Now, he was just 29 years old in 1991 when he was diagnosed with Parkinson's disease. He started the charity 20 years ago, and since then, the Michael J. Fox Foundation has played a very important role in developing therapies. But the foundation's goal is to eliminate Parkinson's completely. Thank you to Michael J. Fox and his foundation and all of its donors for all of their work to help make that goal a reality. And to close today's show, this one comes from Helena, Alabama. Ninth grader Fred Grooms thought his coach was taking him and a few other players to meet the refs before their football game, but Fred actually had a big surprise waiting for him.
So you make sure you get all officials' faces down. Know them good. You know, to your captain, if you look them over, you
Now, in case you didn't pick up on that, one of the people dressed as a ref, that's really Fred's dad, who just returned home from a year-long military deployment. I don't know if I'd be able to play after that, but you know what? Fred probably actually had the game of his life, knowing his dad was there watching the entire time, and you can just see the love there. We love a good reunion. And that'll do it for your good news break this week. Remember, keep sending your good news our way by using the hashtag GoodNewsCLE when you post online, uploading pictures, videos, and your stories using the Near Me feature on the WKYC app, or by emailing us at goodnews@wkyc.com. And we would love it if you would like and share this video, subscribe to our WKYC YouTube page, and follow us on social media at WKYC on Twitter and WKYC3 on Instagram. And I'll see you next time, friends.